Hey guys, it's me, Cruel, back again with another reaction video on this channel. Today we'll be checking out a Dreamcatcher comeback called Boca. I haven't seen any teasers other than some image teasers where I saw Pink Gaion and that killed me. And I'm about to hop to Gaion bias. I'm sorry, Yuyan, but it's about to happen. Let's see if this music video does that for me. It could. Before I get started with this one, if you're new to my channel, I do K-pop reactions every single day. If you want to support me or you want to stay up to date with all the stuff that I do, subscribe to my channel and activate all the notifications on the bell right next to the button. And thank you for doing that if you do. One more thing before we get started. Patreon shoutout for August. Thank you so much for the continued support. I really, really appreciate it. There's more exclusive content on my Patreon, so if you're also interested in that, such as TV show reactions to Road to Kingdom, Island, Good Girl and more in the future, then check the link down in the description below. And yeah, quickly talking about what I see in this thumbnail is obviously the tree. It says part 2 dystopia, lose myself. Lose or lost? I think, lose myself. And the first one was, like, the last one was called the tree of language, of course. And this is the tree, I assume. I didn't understand the story completely in the last music video, and I haven't watched like any story explanation videos on that music video as well, so I'm not gonna pretend like I know the story. I think Gio was like either lost or trapped inside of this tree though. Like, she was kind of tempted to go in and trapped inside, and it looked like Yuyan later broke the curse or something, I'm not sure, and then they left together. That's what I got, but maybe it's wrong, I don't know. That was my, I guess, first impression when I watched the music video back in the day, when it came out back in the day. Anyways, but, before we get started, let's check. There's no subtitles, sadly. That's quite sad, actually. But here we go. I'm ready. And I now have a Dreamcatcher poster as well. It's here. It's from Deja Vu, of course. So, Raid of Dream. And I recently got it. So, I finally have all my favorite groups on my wall. My two old groups, Idol and Mamamoo, then my third favorite group is actually Dreamcatcher, and then my, well, Faza from Mamamoo of course as well, and then my favorite soloist IU here and here, there, with the calendar of the season's greetings. But yeah, I don't know why I went over all of them. I have a Dreamcatcher poster now, so let's go. Oh, by the way, I should have had one for Dystopia Tree of Language. I ordered one together with the album when I pre-ordered it. But it just didn't come. They forgot to send it. Oh well. And I also pre-ordered this album already last week. Okay. Yeah, that's what I was seeing. They were leaving. Wait, this is completely different. Wait, what? This is so modern suddenly. What the hell? Okay. So we're like in an urban city. It looks like this is like some kind of Chinese letter though. And it's not Korean for sure. What did it say? Recycling shop or what? I couldn't read it. I think it says recycling. I don't know if that makes sense. Gaion, okay. I should be good with the members by the way now. I think I know them all. Obviously Hanung is still not here, which is sad, but I'm pretty sure I know them all now. I can recognize them as well. Starting off with Hwandong in Bans. Holy shit. Vocal guy on too. Oh my god. Wait! I have only seen a few teaser pictures. I have not seen the Dami has extensions. Oh my god, Dami with long hair? I have never seen her with long hair actually. Ever since I am an insomnia. And I'm pretty sure one of the teaser pictures she had short hair too, so okay, that happened. Oh my god. Big paradox. Oh my god. I was not ready for long hair Dami. That's she has a completely different vibe. I don't know how to like, I don't know how to process this honestly. This is very different for her. Holy shit. She seems like a different person. Mom, I got you.
Okay.
I'm fine. What are these people, by the way, that are like observing them? They're like so distorted and something. It's weird. Huh. Oh my god, you. Holy shit. Oh, Sua. She's so pretty in that white dress. Holy moly. Jeon! Oh my god, Yuhyun. Oh, there's the rock. There's the rock element. I was wondering where is it gonna be, you know? I was like, okay, there's not gonna be a Dreamcatcher title trick without rock elements. Kind of like Deja Vu was maybe like the one that had the least ones, but yeah, it's not gonna be, so thankfully there's always some of them. I hope they never change, honestly. Like, quick Dreamcatcher talk, I hope they never change their style for title tracks. I know that the B-sides are so different. For any one of you who never listens to Dreamcatcher B-sides, you have to check out some of them at least. Like, honestly, just listen to all of the albums. Like, I know that's a lot to listen to, but they have so many different... I'm convinced that Dreamcatcher has covered every genre there is in the world. I'm pretty sure. Like, they did so many things. They did, I don't know, jazz, ballads, pop ballads, EDM, hip-hop, like, everything. Like, it's so weird. Like, so many different sub-genres as well. Like, techno, like, so many, I don't know... It's so interesting, and the title tracks always have a somewhat similar style that they're trying to be in, and then in that style that they change a lot, so it's not always the same, of course, but it's the style that I really like of the title tracks, and I hope they never change the rock elements, you know, because they don't use instruments and guitar and stuff like that in every B-side, actually, so I hope the title tracks stay like this. I wouldn't be mad if there's gonna be one that it's not, but I hope that in general they will be like this in the future, you know, because I feel like this is Dreamcatcher's key thing, and that's how they got popular. I don't know why they should change now that they are more popular, you know? They're not as popular as they deserve to be, though. Like, they deserve way more, you know? Wait, Jeon now has blue extensions too, or something like that? Like, her bangs are blue and then her ponytail's tail is blue as well. Oh my god, Dami with that long blue hair though. Boka, okay. No! I am not ready for Gaehyun's rap. I am not ready, dude. I am not... I have to though, I have to. Okay, that's he's about to kill me, I know it. Dude, this girl, look at her! Dude, I can't. She's way too beautiful. Oh my fucking god. Dude, our Magne, oh my god. I still can't believe that she's the Magne. I can't. She is not the Magne behavior. That smirk, though. That smirk. That smirk. That smirk. That smirk. That smirk. That reminds me of her, oh my god, how do you pronounce the name? Her IU, Drama. I don't know how to pronounce that fucking song name. That cover, where she had, like, a very cute and a very badass side to her in one video. Holy shit. I can't look at this for too long. Let's go. Right into Dami rap. Oh, I really like the beat change, by the way. Let's repeat that. I don't care. I really like the beat change from the chorus into whatever the second part is. This is so different, what the hell? So different. Dude, this girl! Okay, calm down. Let's go, Dami. Dude, the long hair. Oh my god! Yuhyun. Sua. Shion. What is this, girl? Oh my God, how sexy can she be, man? My God. Look at her, man. How can you not love her? How can you not? Like, go shame on you. Shame on you. Shame on you if you don't like her. Shame on you. You. Oh, Yuyan! Man, I love always how they use Yuyan to ramp up and build up into whatever's gonna happen now, but the instruments kicked in right after her build up. Like, I always like when they use her voice for that, and they use it quite often actually. I think in Digital Wood they did that too. I don't know why. Oh, but it seems to be a pattern. Oh my God! Dude, this video will be way too long. What is this, dude? I can't. Holy shit. Oh, what was that? I really like how they flipped the camera together with, like, how basically Shion flipped the camera. That's so cool. Wait, is it Yuhyun with a bow? I think so, right? What the hell? Dude, Gio is way too fuck. Wait, I muted. Way too freaking beautiful as well. Like, it's not even fair in this yellow dress, especially. Like, what is this? It really reminds me a little bit of Hyuna's flower shower for some reason, this scene. And her look a little bit too, you know? Is this just me? I don't know, but wow, that's. Oh. Let's go! Man, she's such a queen. Oh my God! Oh my God! What is this shot? Oh my God, okay. Wait. Isn't this. Wait, who is this? Is this Shion? Wait, who is this? I'm a bit confused. Isn't this Yuhyun as well? Did she shot herself? Because that looks like an arrow that she shot, you know? Yeah, that's Yuhyun too, right? Oh my God, Sua. Tommy with the blue hair, dude. I can't. Long blue hair. Look at her. Oh my God, what a cry, man. She's so pretty. Please. Please keep long hair. I don't know. I'm not against short hair, but now that I saw this, man. Oh my God, dummy. Okay. Dude, I'm dead. Why is she crying like golden glitter? That's actually interesting. Is it like her makeup? That, like, the makeup that like with the tear together? I don't know. Ah, Shion! Appreciate. Appreciate high note. Look at her on the right there. Look at her. She's the only one not dancing. She's like, I'm having my high note moment. I love that. Oh my God. Oh. Oh, dude. Oh, my heart. My heart. My heart too. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, Yuhyun, but. Oh, it hurts. It hurts, but. Okay. I hopped. Gahyeon bias. Fuck it. I can't resist, dude. I can't resist look at her. I can't resist. I can't. Oh no, I feel bad. Oh my god, no, I feel so bad. Dude, these dresses are insane. Dude, Gio's yellow dress is insane. What is going on in the story, by the way? I'm so confused because, like, this is completely different locations from Scream. Like, it's in the city and then they have this, like, tree that is growing. It's like a, this is like a prequel story or something before the tree was a tree, like when the tree was still really small and not like dangerous. I don't know what's going on. Like, it's the only thing I can really think of. Or they found a new tree. I don't know. I don't know if they found a new tree. Why and do they need a tree? Like, for what? I am very confused with the story. Like, I will not even try to understand it. Like, honestly, just tell me in the comments if you want to. Unless, if not, then I will probably just look it up at some point. Because at this time, I don't even know anymore. But yeah, story wise, I'm confused. Music video wise, this was a fucking treat, dude. Like, I loved this music video. Holy shit. Like, there has not been a single title track from Dreamcatcher that was not, like, that was a disappointment. That, like, all of them were insanely good. Not even music video wise only, but the song as well. It's crazy. None of them is bad at all. Like, all of them are really good. Really freaking good. It started with Chase Me. That was so amazing. Like, Fly High was great. I know that's not an order right now, but I always forget that one title name, actually. Oh, man. It was one after or before Fly High that I always forget. But then what was really, really amazing, dude. Deja Vu was amazing, of course. Pretty was amazing. I'm forgetting songs, but there's dude, obviously Scream and this one now. But, dude, I can't, man. Like, after... what was my favorite title track for a long time? Then Pee Wee came out. I really liked it, but I was like, not sure. And then when Deja Vu came out, it's actually... probably is still my favorite title track, I am not sure. But, like, it's like, if Deja Vu is like a 10 out of 10, then What is a 9.8 out of 10, Pee Wee is 9.7, Scream is a 9.9, this one probably 9.8 or 9.9 as well. Like, it's so hard to decide, I don't know, like, it's so close, and they're all amazingly good. Like, they're all of them are masterpieces, honestly. And they have been getting more, like, in the quality department, definitely getting better over the time, I can tell that. Sound-wise, but also music video-wise, I can tell. But still, the songs itself were all always really good, from the beyond. So, Dreamcatcher is a group, if you don't know them, you're missing out. Please listen to some of their songs, at least the title tracks, right? If you like the title tracks, listen to the albums, because there's so much more to explore. I really regret not checking them out earlier, like the B-sides, that is. I was... only in the title tracks up until the mid or end of last year, actually, for all groups in K-pop, most of them, actually. And Dreamcatcher obviously was one of them, so I was so mad at myself whenever I listened to the title, the B-sides, and I found so many really good songs. It's actually insane. So many good songs. So yeah, this was great. I know this video is really long, but I don't really care at all, because I freaking love Dreamcatcher. I'm gonna fanboy when I watch Dreamcatcher stuff, and I know that. And I didn't even analyze too much. I just fanboyed this video, you know? So, yeah, I don't care, man. Like, I just enjoyed this. I hope you enjoyed my video, though. Like, that would be great on top of that. If not, it is what it is, but that's it, right? That was my video. I hope you enjoyed it. Again, if you did, leave a like and comment down below what I should check out next. And if you didn't subscribe yet, then do that now, please. Yes? Please.